This episode is brought to you by Pet Live. Pet Live is a live answering service. They are 100% U.S. agents, available 24/7, professionally trained on scripts. For more info on how to make your life and business much easier, call 1-800-891-2640 for a 14-day free trial. Welcome to the Joe Mendoza Show. This is where you'll learn tactical business, life, and investment strategies and secrets to take you to the next level much faster and easier. Your host, Joe Mendoza, is a top nationwide coach, real estate pro, investor, and entrepreneur. He has trained hundreds of powerful business leaders and investors across the nation. Mr. Mendoza owns, operates, and has invested in multiple businesses and is constantly seeking more investment opportunities. And now your host, Mr. Joe Mendoza.
Hello, hello. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Today, we're going to be talking about whatever it takes. The Raptors just beat the Golden State Warriors in a National Basketball Association Championship 2019. Kind of brought me back a little bit to one of my sports experiences. I want to kind of address some of the folks out there that aren't the superstar champions, that just kind of average warrior out there. And I had an experience that I had to do whatever it takes. How many of you have ever run a marathon? It's not the easiest thing in the world. Not too many people out there do it. I talk to a lot of runners, these weekend warriors, these 5K people, these half marathon. I asked them, have you ever done a marathon? Or they would share with me like they've never done a marathon. So I know it's not easy. How do I know? Well, I actually did one in 2001. I took this one training called Landmark Education a while back in 2001. And one of the things that came out of it was like I got this crazy idea. Hey, let's go run a marathon. Started training. When you start training for a marathon, you don't just run 26.2 miles right away. You have to build up for it. Week one, a mile a day. Week two, 3 miles a day. You don't just run a marathon your first weekend or your first day. You're going to kill yourself. A lot of things happened. I went through a middle of a move. I was training for, man, maybe it was 5 months or so. I kind of fell off the wagon off of training. A month later, I was sitting down with my brother-in-law, and he goes, hey, so how's that training for that marathon going? And I go, I'm not doing it. Dude, you work so hard at it. Why are you just going to go ahead and give up and all that training and what have you? He then says, well, Joe, if you do it, I'll do it. And keep in mind, this guy was not planning to run the marathon at all. I mean, he didn't even train for it, but he had some background of doing a marathon, and he ran on and off, but he didn't really train for this one. It was crazy because it was like the next day, not training for a month, and him calling me out. Well, of course, I said, yes, okay, I'll do it. He kind of convinced me to do it. He made me pull out my man card, and I said, okay, I'll go ahead and do it. If you do it, I'll do it. And sure enough, next day he showed up to the race, and the rest was history. So I got to the front of the race when the gun's about to start, and I'm looking for my brother-in-law, and he's not there yet. And so I'm waiting. There's like hundreds of thousands of people here. How the hell am I going to find this guy? It's like 10 minutes into the race. He's still not here. And I might as well just get going. And waiting all that time, drinking all that water in the morning, I'm like, man, I got to use a restroom. And so I had to find the nearest porta potty. I had to jump in line because there was a large line in front of me. Then I got out. I waited a little bit longer and still didn't see him. And now we're 30 minutes or so into the race. and finally shows up. And craziness, because we weren't running, we were barely jogging, if not walking. We probably finished our first mile in like across the mile one, and it was 45 minutes into the race on mile one, guys. And so I knew I was in for a very, very long day. My brother-in-law, he was like, "Hey, Joe, just pace yourself. You know, our number one job today is just to finish. Who cares about our time? We're going to do whatever it takes." I just trusted in him, you know, blind faith. He's done one before. He knows what we're up against. Let's go. All right. And so mile two, mile three, mile four, and we finally get to the halfway point. And we start seeing some people just falling back, injured. You know, you go through the halfway mark, and then you're looking at the time, and they're like, holy smoke. You know, most people are already done with the race, you know, in less than 3 hours. And here we are. You know, we're like 3 hours or so into the race, and we're barely halfway. So you could kind of imagine our time for the end of the race, right? You know, you get to mile 16 and 17 and 18, and finally you hit that the wall, they call it, right? Mile 21 or so. And that's when the wall really happens, because at that point, you know, seriously, my body was breaking down. I could barely stand up. I was hands on the porta potty on the wall, just leaning over, hunched over, couldn't barely stand because I beat myself up, you know, for zero training in 1 month before the race with my brother-in-law there helping me, mentoring me and encouraging me through the race, and my mindset of, hey, I'm just going to do whatever it takes to get through. And I pushed and I persevered, and finally, we were hitting mile 25, and I could see the finish line. I could hear the crowd, and that really inspired me to push. I crossed the finish line, and what's super ironic about this whole darn thing is when I registered for the marathon, I wrote down, I am gonna finish 7 hours was my limit. I think I put something like 6:59:59 or 7 hours. I forget what it was, because there's a limit when you run a marathon. They can't keep it open forever. And I said, hey, I'm just going to finish. This is my first marathon ever. My job is to finish. I'm just going to do whatever it takes. And at the end of the race, I finished at 6:57:57. Not too many people have done a marathon or can do a marathon, but I did whatever it takes. How many of you out there are willing to do whatever it takes in whatever goal, business, thing that you're doing? That was just one day of my life, guys. But on that journey, you know, I just had that mindset of doing whatever it takes to finish. It was awesome that I had somebody there by my side. Now, without him, I honestly don't think I would have finished. I definitely wasn't going to do it without him, because my mind was already made up that I was quitting. I was not going to do it. But then he reminded me of the goal. He encouraged me to keep persevering. A marathon is not a joke. This message is for the average, the regular person out there, that once in a while, guys, you can be great. You can be extraordinary. It takes a decision. It takes a mentor. It takes work. You got a goal. Do whatever it takes. It may not be easy. It may be freaking ugly. But once you make that commitment, once you get extra help, once you persevere, the rest is history. Apply it to the rest of your life, your business, what have you. Hopefully you enjoyed the show. Joe Mendoza, signing out. Take care. God bless. Thanks so much for listening. And please share the story. Get inspired and get out there and do something. Take care.